So thank you very much. During the sessions, during these days, we have been talking a lot about the energy transition. And in this particular, today, we would like to share with you some details about the Wind for Hydrogen Alliance, that stands for a whole Iberian network for hydrogen that pretends to foster the green hydrogen mobility in Spain. As it is well known, the European Union has is fostering the reduction of the emissions that are producing the rise of the global temperature and to achieve a climate neutrality by 2050. And in this sense, last year it was published the European strategy to develop the green hydrogen value chain. And obviously this has been reflected in the Spain's hydrogen roadmap that was published also last year. As you can see on the slide, the roadmap includes several targets for 2030 and includes a variety of topics, including electrolysis capacity, refueling stations, vehicles on the road, and especially target investments to develop the green hydrogen industry. As it is well known, the green hydrogen has several applications, but today we will be focusing on a very concrete and by now a niche area, that is the use for mobility, where it is expected that between 2025 and 2035, depending on the application, if it is for light vehicles, for heavy transportation, and so on, it is expected to be the most efficient solution, both competing with the traditional sources, so the fuels, the current fuels, as well as most efficient than the green solution. This is a good expectation, and is pushing many companies to bid for it. However, the journey is not exempted from certain challenges that especially include the cost of hydrogen, the cost of the not only the production, but the cost at the pump, or at the, in this case, perhaps it's better to say, at the compressor point, so just before refilling the vehicles, the availability of the refilling infrastructure, and especially also the cost of the vehicles that most of the off-takers are facing nowadays, prices that may range or that may go up to three times an alternative using standard fuels. So it's in this environment where Exolum and Naturgy have decided to join forces and to create the Wind for Hydrogen Alliance, which goal is to develop an integrated network of hydrogen refueling stations, green hydrogen refueling stations, in Spain to allow users to move freely throughout the country without being concerned on the refueling points, no? And creating by that, or articulating what we call the green hydrogen routes or corridors throughout the country. And in a first stage, we foresee that this may be used especially by the heavy road transportation services, either for goods or for passengers. In the slides that we'll be sharing with all of you, you can find more information about Exolum and Naturgy. But today I would like to focus on a few of the characteristics of the two companies, characteristics that we believe make the partnership a winning one, that are, first of all, is the that we are offering an integral solution for the customers, and we offer the hydrogen as a service. So we are, let's say, making it very easy for the off-takers to adopt this technology and covering the whole value chain, from the production of the green power, the electrolysis of the hydrogen, the storage, the purification, the compression, and the distribution through the hydrogen refueling points. And obviously to offer the best price, no? So we'll be making these combinations and getting involved in the different parts of the value chain to minimize the price of the hydrogen to the customer. The second characteristic is the financial capacity of the companies. I think we both enjoy from a healthy balance sheet, and this is very important to face these investments, which are not small. But however, this financial capacity, I think one of the challenges that that the development of this type of initiatives is that it requires a significant amount of subsidies from the government. It's happening all over Europe. It's happening also in Spain. It's starting in the last months. So we expect this support to be increasing in the coming months. And the last characteristic of the two companies is the guarantee of supply. For both of us, is critical to secure the supply of whatever products we offer to the customer. Today, they are fuels, chemicals, gas, power, and tomorrow we want to make the same for hydrogen and to make sure that the customers keep on trusting how we do things. And these characteristics will be also embedded, or we are trying to embed in this alliance. Now I hand over to my colleague Jacobo from Naturgy, who will be giving also some additional details on the goals of the alliance and especially the point where we are currently.
Thank you, Andres. I am Jacobo Regojo from Naturgy, and it's a pleasure to be with you. My concern is try to, as Andres said, try to give you more details of the goals that you already obtained from the project. As you can see in the slide, our first target is to cover all of the area of Spain. As you can see, we are proposing around 50 stations to cover all over Spain and connected, as you can see in the map, between France and Portugal. This is very important to understand that this project has to be covered and covered by the rest of the European intention to cover all of Europe about the use of hydrogen for transportation. So this is for us an important case of study. In the first phase of the project, our intention, as you are seeing in the map, is to cover the area between Madrid and Levante, that cover Madrid, Levante, and Cartagena, because this is one of the first phases that we understand that the demand of transportation in Spain could be developed. So for us, it's very important to understand that it's impossible to do it at all of the end. So we need to start for a first phase. So we think to start with Madrid, Valencia, Cartagena is one of the ideas to obtain the first helps of European funds. And we are going to connect and to, you can see here in some of the details of the tons of hydrogen and the equivalence of vehicles that we can cover with this production. So as you can see, this is the first phases at the first companies that are proposing a national network to cover all over the European idea, okay? For you can see that all of our design are going to be modular. It means that we are going to cover a demand for the beginning and after we can grow. This idea is not new, it's an idea that everybody knows, but the idea is to growing at the same time as the demand is growing, because without that, it's very difficult to catch this demand, okay? So I think that somebody here in this expo already talked about the idea, and for us, the idea is very important, and we are going to focus on it, okay? So you can see that we are going to get the production, we are going to get the storage, and we are going to get the supply. The question here about the pressure, this is one of the things that we already like to handle out, that we are talking about now 350. The intention is to have all of the stations ready to prepare for 700, because now the developing in the transportation and all of our mobility area is growing to this pressure, this level of pressure. So we will see how develop of these manufacturers and our cell is growing up, okay? So here you can see the preliminary designs that we are having, the lower storage, the medium storage, and this is all a technical issue that already is developed on the project, and as I'm saying, it's very important to understand that all are going to be modular, okay? To growing with the develop of the project. I'm not sure what, okay. According with the locations, for us, it's important to understand that some locations are fixed and some locations are going to be touched with the possibility of growing the demand. It means if you can see here, in according with the map, all of the fixed location are around of 150 tons per year, because this is the value that we obtain. This is a reference of value for our design, because one of the things that the funds of European funds require to the project is we need to make designs that can be as mass as homologability for other projects and other sites. So we decided to take a production of 150. So we are now proposing a portable station to catch the rest of the demand. And in the way that the demand is confirmed, we propose to make a new physics stations. Okay, so this is the idea, to have physics and portable stations. As you can see here in the portable station, you can see all of the area of Spain that we are trying to get with this portable station. It means we are going to have fixed station, as I saw, that Madrid, Valencia, Murcia, and maybe in the future could be Cuenca, but at the same time, we are going to cover an area bigger to obtain if those demands could be developed and after propose a fixed station, okay? I think this way of working is one of the ideas that we think is a good idea to develop the hydrogen for mobility in Spain. Okay, just to have a brief summary about the schedule that everybody can understand. Now we are today we are in the way of the taking the project with the stakeholders, of course definition and finalizing all of the technical point of the projects, and of course at the end of the process, the target is at the end of 2023 to have the first station in Spain according with the schedule that the European funds already required to us. Okay. Well, just to confirm where we are at the moment, it's very important to understand in this slide that everybody have to be in the same project. It means not only ourselves, because we are providing the infrastructure, but also we need to be with us, the stakeholders. We also have to be the manufacturers of the vehicles. Our customers need to buy vehicles. Without vehicles in Spain, it's going to be very difficult to sell our hydrogen. So it means that we are everybody in the same circles, okay? At the same time, just to everybody knows, it's important to know the calendars that the European funds is giving to us. We already present the Mobile Singularis in Spain, and we already have a prefactation of our project. Also, some days ago, we presented the PERTE Pioneros to Europe, and we are preparing. Now we are starting to prepare all of the technical developments and permits, and after we are continue with the commercial contract to be ready everything at the end of this year to start the construction. This is one of our targets, and we hope with all of us could be achieve this target. Okay, just to be in the end, and I mentioned, and it's a good thing to summary in our presentation, is to understand that we are in the middle of the chain value, and we are trying to make a chain value collaborate, an economical collaborate value to everybody. It means we are in the production, storage, and supply, but we are trying to connect the supply and manufacturers with the off-takers. And this is, for us, is the most important of the presentation. Without that, it's impossible to develop for mobility in Spain this project and other projects like this one. Okay, so thank you so much for your time. Now Andres and myself are ready to answer any question or any issue that you could be helpful, and thank you so much for your time. It's a pleasure. Maybe everything is clear, I'm not sure.
Either everything is clear or you're eager to hear the next presentation. Are there any questions at the moment?
We've seen with traditional fuels that usually the vehicle manufacturers lead but I get the impression that are they lagging at the moment, or do you see them actually taking a lead here as well?
Well, thank you so much for the question, because I think it's correct. In our conversation with these companies, they are now using the actual consumptions, but it's ready that they are asking for the new consumptions. So now when we present for them the projects, we are also presenting that they have new manufacturers for vehicles that they can obtain, and those companies are giving to them offers, not only for the vehicles, but also for the funds that they can obtain for the new vehicles. And for us, this is completely, it's very, very important for the project that those companies receive those funds, because they are going to receive the new vehicles with the new hubs. Without that, it's going to be a little bit difficult. But that is true, that they are asking to us for this new technology. That's true.
If I may add, yes, we have seen that the manufacturers are not, they say you cannot go to the dealer and ask for a bus or a truck powered by hydrogen. So it's needs to be ordered, and it takes a few months. So it's not in the production line of the manufacturers right now. I think the reason is that there is not a significant demand to justify, let's say, the industrialization of the manufacturing. No, but we expect this will come. No, one of the reasons we think is not happening is that especially the funds, at least in the case of Spain, are being divided for different parts of the value chain, and they are not synced. So there are subsidies for producers of hydrogen, there are subsidies to acquire a vehicle, but there is not a subsidy to cover the whole value chain, enable the articulation of a single project of this nature, covering all the needs of the different parties. So there is a little bit of disconnection, and we are all a little bit cautious on the steps we take. No, so I think this is the normal thing when a new industry is getting developed, no?
But if I may add, you seem to be getting there, and you know, you're talking about something that is maybe actually going to happen, and we can go and take photographs of in 2023.
One of our bits. I mean, the demand is still not there, but the commitment of the both companies is to have at least these four refueling points ready by the coming end of next year. So we'll be there. So there will be no excuse for an off-taker saying, I cannot refill hydrogen.
That's
so
right.
It will be there. So it's like our little contribution to the industry. Perhaps it's not a big deal. It's not a megas or gigas of projects or electrolyzing capacity. But I think if we can make it, it will make a significant difference, even though it may seem too small.
Yeah, it's like the first stone of the process. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.